According to the latest numbers last updated on 3rd of June 2021 from Johns Hopkins COVID cases, the COVID-19 global death rate has surpassed 3 million, and despite this, low-income countries have received less than 1% of the total 773 million worldwide administered doses of COVID-19 vaccine. 75 million doses were to be acquired for Africa, but as of now, only 12 million doses have been delivered. In Kenya, 953,954 people have been vaccinated for their first dose of COVID-19 as of 23rd May 2021. Experts approximate that 4 million people are most at risk, but only 1 million vaccine doses are currently available.
Now that corona
Sister,
is here
corona
and vaccine is covered in 9 months, how should I trust the vaccine, having children being subjected to this vaccine? Then afterwards, things go bad. What will I tell my children, especially the girls, when they ask me what happened, they don't get children or give birth?
Misinformation and traditional beliefs in Kenya have led to vaccine hesitancy. I sought to find out why and what could be the remedy to this.
Misinformation that we have in the social media saying that these vaccines have not been tested in animals, that some faces have been jammed, therefore we are not sure about their safety, have largely contributed to vaccine hesitancy. But there is no fact about that. There are more than 200 vaccines that have been tested in animals but did not progress to human testing because of safety concern. So you can tell that many vaccines have stopped at a very early stage just because of safety concerns.
One unfortunate effect of COVID-19 pandemic is a decline in routine vaccination for children, with data from the government's District Health Information System software, DHIS2, which handles reporting, analysis and dissemination of data for all health system and program, shows that children that were fully immunized in 10 counties in Kenya within 2 years stood at 365,551.
It is important to remember that it's not vaccines that saves lives, it's actually vaccination. So we need the vaccines to be available and for people to be vaccinated. And the key questions to be asked to many countries, what have they done about their health systems to be able to ensure that when the vaccines come, they are actually able to vaccinate people?
Halima Abubakar, a 32-year-old mother of 9 who lives in Eastleigh, an estate in Kenya's capital Nairobi, has not been able to take her children for vaccination for several years as recommended by the Ministry of Health.
For me, I have my own stress to look for milk for my children and I'm unable to take them to hospital. This house need rent. If no one is not helping me, I have to work through. I am the one looking for food, paying rent, everything is on me.
It was not until 2018 when a community health volunteer CHV knocked on her door. To help her cut the cost of taking care of her big family, Abubakar sent 3 of her children to live with her mother in Mandera County, while she supports with the remaining 6 on the major income she gets from selling clothes in the busy stalls within Eastleigh.
So you find that in these households, they have got so many challenges. The lady is single. She has been divorced twice. And managing that stress is not easy. Getting food for the children is not easy. And even making follow-up for the health issues, it is not easy. So during her time when she's busy looking for food for the children, she cannot even think to take children for immunization.
Halima would love to see her children live a healthy life, but given her dire economic situation, this remains a wish that she hopes her children will save her from in future. She was hit hard by the suspension of learning introduced by the government in response to COVID-19, and during this period, she would lock her children in her two-roomed house, putting her children at risk.
I'll give an example. We went to some of the suburbs of Nairobi, where like the Gureti, near Junction. And we found some of the uptake of immunization of 30%. We found a mother with a child who was 7-year-old, 10-year-old, 3-year-old, who have never taken a child for immunization. And therefore the question is why? The mothers tell us, well, nobody came to me and reminded us. And therefore that started now telling us who should have reminded this mother. He said the doctor, he said the nurse, he said the neighbor.
With the rise of misinformation, latest statistics drawn from vaccine project implemented in 17 counties in Kenya, dubbed Healthy Strengthening Services Project, HSS, spearheaded by Kenya AIDS Consortium and the Gavi Vaccine Alliance, including the government, have tasked the local health volunteers to trace over 100,000 children who have defaulted from vaccination due to vaccine hesitancy.
I normally have a checklist. I just have to ask generally about how is their health at the moment. So they say everything, maybe I'm sick, the children are coughing. So out of that, I refer them to the health facility. And for the under fives, I have to make sure I check the clinic book. But maybe for this situation that we are visited right now, I've been coming, sometimes I check the booklet, sometimes you come, you find the booklet is nowhere to be seen, maybe the mother has misplaced or even the children have torn it apart. So we just encourage them to go and finish up the immunization.
Vaccine hesitancy is a delay in acceptance or refusal of vaccine despite the availability of vaccine services, caused by a number of factors, including safety concern, lack of trust in the institution administering the vaccine, and misinformation, which worsens the situation.
Information about the performance of the vaccines and picking up any issue around safety that might arise in the future. So I think we can be really well assured that we have a very strong system in place to both look at safety, assure safety before a vaccine is authorized for use, and will continue to monitor safety even after it is deployed for widespread use.
The World Health Organization has identified vaccine hesitancy as a leading global health threat. And with this in mind, I spoke to Professor Walter Jaoko, a professor of medical biology and tropical medicine at the University of Nairobi, and currently involved in the HIV research and COVID-19 clinical trials.
Issues of blood clot, because that is another thing that has made people very hesitant to getting the vaccine. But also to remind the viewers and the audience that blood clots are caused by other things as well. And even medicines that we know are associated with blood clots, we have never stopped using them. We just do what we call a risk assessment and determine who can get the medicine or not. So for example, oral contraceptive that has been used for many, 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 many years have a higher risk of giving blood clots than the COVID vaccines that we have in the market today. So you just assess and you determine, you do your risk benefit analysis, and you determine who can get the vaccine and who cannot.
The country director of AIDS Health Foundation, AHF Kenya, Dr. Samuel Kinyanjui, and WHO's Dr. Catherine O'Brien, demystifies the misinformation that vaccines are harmful to Kenyans.
A rhetoric question. If these vaccines are not good for people, they will make people infertile or they'll kill people in 2 years. Why the West? Why are the rich countries hunting four times the volume they need for their population? Why are they holding something that is so bad? That's the question I'd like all of us to ask themselves, to think through, to process this, and understand that the misinformation that's coming through is just to make that people from poor countries not demand, not see the injustice that is being propagated against them by the rich countries who are holding the vaccines.
The World Health Organization, WHO, UNICEF and Gavi, the Vaccine Alliance, have called for the urgent need for the renewed global commitment to improve vaccination access and uptake, and key stakeholders need to move quickly to plug the gap in vaccinations for both children and adults during the pandemic to avoid future potential health crises.
Latency is a big problem, and a lot of this is because of misinformation. What I find very sad is that we are talking about the disproportion that you've seen about 81% of the people, the vaccines being given in the rich countries, with the less being given here. But the message about hesitancy targets so much the resource-limited countries. You'd not get those vaccines given in the West if the hesitancy was equal there. But everybody, and I see a lot of WhatsApp messages, and we're very quick in forwarding messages that are coming from anti-vaccine lobbies in the West, and we buy it, you know, line, sink, and everything. And we are passing it to our people, increasing the vaccine hesitancy, whereas the West are getting all these vaccines. So people get these messages, they don't think about it, they just keep on forwarding it to other people, and it has contributed a lot. Somebody just put something here on the media that there was a message that people who've gotten vaccines will die in 2 years. I have seen that in I don't know how many groups that I belong to. And people just keep on forwarding and forwarding and forwarding. So we are actually enemies to ourselves by contributing to this vaccine hesitancy.
Vaccines are a vital component of public health, and it is paramount to keep demystifying the key information about vaccine efficacy, delivery, and necessity in order to prevent the likelihood of misinformation creeping in. For Straight News TV, I'm Odi Francis. Story proudly sponsored by African Resilience Network.